Once upon a time, there was a little ogre named Shrek who lived with his parents in a bog by a tree.
It was a pretty nasty place, but he was happy because ogres like nasty.
On his birthday, the little ogre's parents sat him down to talk,
just as all ogre parents had for hundreds of years before.
You're growing up so quickly. Growing up bigger by the day.
Although we want you here, the rules are very clear.
Now you're seven.
Now you're seven.
So it's time to go away.
Your mama packed a sandwich for your trip. Your papa packed your boots in case of snow. You're gonna make us proud, no backing up allowed. Just keep walking, and you'll find somewhere to go. It's a big, bright, beautiful world with happiness.
The little ogre found himself a muddy patch of swampland.
Far, far away where the world had despised him. And there he stayed away for many years.
Tucked away and all alone.
Which is just the way I like it.
Keep your big, bright, beautiful world. I'm happy where I am, all alone. I got all I need, so read the stinking sign. A big, bright, beautiful world. I party on my own anyway, doing what I can with a one-man conga line. And it's mine alone, and it's mine, and it's mine. All mine.
The mud, you'll get used to it.
This place is a dump.
It's not fit for a pig.
Hello,
we can hear you.
Look, you all read Lord Farquaad's decree.
Yeah, we read it. All fairy tale creatures have been banished from the kingdom of Duloc. All fruitcakes and freaks are hereby evicted.
All right, when I call your name, step forward. Pinocchio?
Oh, I'm not a puppet. I'm a real boy.
That's your patch of mud down there. Gingerbread man? I said gingerbread man. Anybody seen the gingerbread man?
He's been missing for days.
Yes. That's right.
Dump on the swamp. Man, I tell you, sometimes being a fairy tale creature sucks pine sap.
Whoa, is what I know. Out above my nose,
over there by that sign. No, that's too far. Too close. Ah, just right. Wicked Witch.
Strife! It's never ending.
Peter Pan.
Vanish from the town.
Ugly Duckling.
They dragged me from the pond. They broke my magic wand.
Three Pigs.
But a witch hunt.
Mama Bear.
Mama's in the mud, Mama's in distress.
They ridiculed my hat.
They said that we were fat.
They labeled me a fisherman because I wore a granny dress.
Park it there, Wolf.
Story of my life. Booted from the bar, the party's off the hook.
I threw into a wall.
That's the story of my life.
And remember, if we find you back in the kingdom, you will be.
What are you all doing in my swamp?
Well, gosh, we were forced to come here.
Forced? By who?
Lord Farquaad, I hope that people beside you to make the notice.
Well, not my problem. Now you all need to turn around and go back where you came from.
Go back? We can't go back.
The guy is bad news.
Hey, maybe you could talk to him.
Yeah, he'll listen to you. You're big and scary.
I'm also an ogre, which means I stay on my swamp, avoid large crowds, or haven't you read the stories?
You mean the stories where Sam the big bad wolf?
And the stories of Sam a wicked witch?
But the ones that say I'm a wooden boy? What? I'm not a wooden boy. I have a glandular condition.
Look here, ogre, I'ma spell it out for you. You're the only tough one to stand up to this no good Flynn Farmer Farquaad.
Yeah! Okay, fine, I get it. I'ma go talk to this Farquaad guy right now, get you all off my land and back where you came from.
Yeah!
Now this can't be right. I'm all turned around. I took a right at the candy house, past the old lady in the shoe, and took a left at Mary's Little House and Lamb Chops.
Ah! I'm a doggy, I was a bitch in my coat!
It's hideous.
That's not very nice. It's just a donkey.
Step aside, Shrek, and let us at him.
Why? What'd he do?
It's a talking donkey, a freak of nature as of you unsavory beast.
Hey, now, you're going the right way for a smackdown.
By the order of Lord Farquaad, I'll place both of you under arrest.
Under arrest, eh?
Ah!
This is the part where you run away. And don't come back. Now, which way to Duloc?
Can I just say that was incredible, man? They were tripping over themselves to get away from you. I like that.
Ah, that's nice. Now, why don't you go celebrate your narrow escape with your friends?
But I don't have any friends.
Wow, now there's a shocker.
You're funny. So you're lost or something?
No, I'm just looking for the best watch at Duloc.
Oh, I know Duloc! I know Duloc! You gotta let me show you the way! Because I'm like a GPSer.
I'll be fine on my own. Thanks.
But nobody's fine at all. Not when you look like we do. Say, didn't you hear what they said, man? This place is going step forward. We gotta join forces, otherwise they're gonna lock me up, and I cannot go back in the cage. I don't know if I mentioned it or not, but I did 6 years in solitary for impersonating Piñata.
Fine, only because I'm lost who can come.
Yeah, woohoo, all right!
Under one condition, you keep your jabbering to a minimum.
You got it, no jabbing. Man, you will not regret this.
It's too late.
Now that's what I'm talking about. Second donkey, I'll find a big city adventure.
The man who made it happen.
That tower collapses of Foxy. Lord Farquaad!
Oh, it's you. What a terrific surprise. And look at you. You hear a torture sign. Bring in the cookie.
No, no. I won't speak. I won't. Oh, it's you.
Run, run as fast as you can. You can't catch me. I'm the gingerbread man.
You're a monster.
I'm not the monster here. You are. You never said that fairy tale chance was in my perfect kingdom.
It's not a kingdom because you're not a king.
I will be. Just as soon as I find a princess to marry. I hear you're no one. Tell me where she is.
Bite me.
That's it. My patience has reached the end. Present the devices of torture.
Now, wait a minute. Let's not get crazy here. Maybe you have heard tell of a princess?
From who?
Do you know the Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man.
The Muffin Man who lives on Dairy Lane?
Well, I heard of the Muffin Man.
The Muffin Man?
The Muffin Man!
He heard it from the Muffin Man.
Can I go now?
You haven't told me where she is!
I can't!
You must!
I won't!
Tell me, Earl!
No! Not my body! Not my gumdrop body!
Then tell me where she is!
Okay, I'll tell you. She's at the Aesmon premiere in the Dragon Garden Castle, surrounded by hot boiling lava.
Well, that sounds dangerous.
You want a princess or not?
Go on!
In the Dragon Garden Castle, in the highest room in the tallest tower, you will find a fiery redhead named Princess Fiona.
Ooh, Princess Fiona. She does perfect, same with the dragon lava thing. I have to find someone else to go.
Big surprise.
I shall make Princess Fiona my queen, and Dula go find out his perfect king. Guards, take the cookie to the swamp with the rest of the fairy tale freaks.
Swamp? That's the thanks I get?
My loyal subjects! We're having a queen! Maestro!
Thank you.
you can shout.
I know, he's gonna read the thing. He's gonna tell us a story.
People of Duloc, the moment you've all been waiting for. The raffle determining who sent forth to rescue Princess Fiona from the fiery keep of the dragon.
Excuse me? Like I've never heard that reaction before. Are you Lord Farquaad?
Maybe. Does the name strike fear in your heart?
No, but the little hat does.
Who let this thing in here?
Look, I'll be out of your silky hair just as soon as you give me my swamp back.
Your swamp?
Yeah, where you dunked all those fairy tale things.
That new flash ogre, that oozing mud pit of yours, is in the province of Duloc, therefore mine.
Look here, Half Pint.
Wait, this is too perfect.
What is?
You're big and hulking. People of Duloc, we have a winner! Congratulations, Ogre. You won the honor of embarking on a great noble quest.
But we're already on a quest.
To get my swamp back.
You nearly accomplished it. You just need to bring Princess Fiona to me, to bring her to me to marry, and I'll hand over the deed to you. Guard, give the fight, Royal Highness. I shall make Princess Fiona my queen, and Duloc will finally have his perfect king. Things are looking up here in Duloc. And no one's gonna bring me down.
Well, that was odd.
Not as odd as you agreeing to go on this quest. What do you know about rescuing a princess?
I've read the stories.
And I read the sports read. That won't make me a hockey player.
Look, it says she's been stuck in a castle since she was 7.
Only 7 years old?
Sounds like a cue for a flashback, doesn't it?
Who are you talking to?
No one. Let's go.
It's story time, there's a princess in a tower. Oh my gosh, that's just like me. Poor Rapunzel needs a haircut, but the witch won't set her free. She passes time by singing, like so, no, so, no. As you go by, she says to it, as you go by. Uh-oh, a torturous existence, I don't remember this part. She wishes she was dead, skip ahead. But in the end, Rapunzel finds a millionaire. The prince is good at climbing and braiding golden hair. So I know he'll appear, and his armor will be blinding, as shining as his perfect teeth. And then he hopes he'll propose on one knee. That's
a hero in love in seconds flat. No one needs these middle bits. Whoops, did I do that? Cut the villains, cut the vamping, cut this fairy tale, cut the peril and the pitfalls, cut the puppet in the well, cut the monsters, cut the curses, keep the intro, cut the verses and the waiting, the waiting, the waiting, the waiting, the waiting. Are you there, God? It's me, Fiona. It's me, Fiona. Now I know he'll appear. There are rules and there are scriptures. I believe the story beside me. By candlelight, by white night, by night and sea.
There's a lot more to ogres than people think.
Example?
Example. Okay, onions. Ogres are like onions.
They stink?
Yes. No.
They make you cry?
No.
Oh, you leave them out in the sun and they get all brown and start sprouting little hairs.
No. Ogres have layers, onions have layers. Ogres have layers, onions have layers. We both have layers.
Oh, you both have layers. You know, not everybody likes onions. Parfaits! Everyone likes parfaits. And have you ever met a person that says, hey, let's go get some parfaits? And they say, no, I don't like no parfaits. Parfaits are delicious.
I don't care. Parfaits are not like, ogres are not like parfaits.
Parfaits must be the most delicious thing on the whole planet.
You know, this might turn to the longest day in my entire life.
Ooh, I got the perfect melody for that one.
Oh no, I'm not interested.
Sing a song, yes, a travel song, when you got to go somewhere. Cause the fun is getting there. Oh, what the heck, I must confess, I love a road trip. Sing a song, hit the trail. Forget the map, forget the guide. Before you know it, you made strides with me. Before you know it, you may try to.
That'll do it, Donkey. That'll do it.
You did good, bro. Don't leave. Don't leave. No. Hey, look, the dragon's keep. You're right, that did make time go faster.
Phew, Shrek, was that you, man? You had one swim before you just cracked one off on me. My mouth was open and everything.
Trust me, Donkey, if it was me, you'd be dead. It's brimstone.
Yeah, right, brimstone. I know where I smell it, it's no brimstone. And it didn't come from no stone either.
Hey, look. This will come in handy. Hope it's fireproof. All right, Donkey, you stay here and I'll be back.
Wait here, you mean by myself?
Unless you'd rather slay the dragon than rescue the princess.
Oh no, waiting here is fine. Hurry back!
I can't see anything.
Shrek, I heard a war! Shrek, I'm 2 seconds away from leaving you here! This place is creepy!
You don't even know the half of it. Sorry.
Shrek, come back! There's people with beards!
You don't want to wake her up.
She gets really mad.
Who are you people? What are you talking about?
We're knights. We came to rescue the princess.
Just like you.
None of us made it, though.
She keeps us around because we sing backup.
What? Dragon, I'm out of here!
That's what we thought.
Oh my goodness, oh my goodness, oh my goodness!
That's what we did.
Dragon!
That's what we said.
Another day in Tamaki. I get no rest, I get no sleep. Cause when I start to count my sheep, you come around.
I'll come back later then.
She dropped the shades and
no one wants to rescue me, so yeah, I'm a little bitter. I'm no princess, no great beauty. No one ever, 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 ever wants me.
Hold on, I got something to say here. First of all, I'm not a knight. I'm a donkey. And if you don't know that, you gotta get your eyes checked. Secondly, that person isn't even my type at all. Not my type at all. Cause I like my girls tall, mean, and curvy. So I hope you learned something valuable today. And now if you excuse me, I'll be on my way. What's the matter with you? You got something in your eye?
I'm no princess, but he wants me. No great beauty, but he wants me. No one ever, 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 ever wanted me. So, you're gonna stay, you're gonna stay, you're gonna stay forevermore. You're gonna love.
Hello? Anyone up there? Shouldn't you toss down, like, hair or something? No? All right, then. Oh, phew. We got one of the snoozers. Wake up! Are you Princess Fiona?
I am. Wait, a knight so bold as to rescue me.
That's nice. Now let's go.
But wait, Sir Knight, I have long awaited this day, and I would as first like to know what's the name of my champion.
Shrek?
Sir Shrek, I pray that you take this favor as a token of my gratitude.
Thanks. All right. Let's go.
Now hold this on, Sir Knight. Don't you want to savor this moment? It beeth our first meeting. It must be a wonderful and romantic scene.
Ah, jeez, I'm like a crackpot magnet.
You didn't slay the dragon?
It's on my to-do list. Come on, let's go. Donkey!
Shrek!
Dragon! Run! This is how I pictured it. More or less, I must admit, a thumping in my heart, a life about to start. I knew this day would come, and you would find your way.
You know, Princess, we could really use some help here. No, nothing. Best day ever.
It would be today!
This is it. Shrek here found an axe laying in the tired old castle. And I cut this rope, and then bam! The half-looking chandelier fell on the dragon's head, and that's how we escaped. And the fire-breathing dragon. Who the man? Shrek the man.
You did it. You're amazing. You're wonderful. You're a little unorthodox. I'll admit, but thy deed is great and thine heart is pure. I am eternally in your debt. And where would a brave knight be without his noble steed?
I hope you heard she called me a noble steed. She think I'm a steed.
Well, Sir Shrek, the battle is won. You may remove your helmet.
No.
Why not?
I have helmet hair.
Please, I wouldn't look upon the face of my rescuer.
No, you wouldn't, Est.
But how will you kiss me?
What? That wasn't the job description.
Maybe it's a perk.
No, it's destiny. A princess is rescued by a brave knight. Then they share true love's first kiss.
With Shrek? You think your Shrek is your true love?
What is so funny?
Well, Princess, let's just say I'm not your type.
Of course you are. You're my rescuer. Now, remove your helmet.
I don't think that's a good idea.
Just take off the helmet.
I'm not going to.
Take it off.
No.
Now.
All right, as you command, Your Highness.
You're an ogre?
You're expecting Prince Charming?
Well, yes, actually. Oh, no! I'm supposed to be rescued by my true love, not by some ogre and his pet.
So much for a noble steed.
You're not supposed to be an ogre.
Look, princess, I was sent to rescue by Lord Farquaad. He's the one that wants to marry you.
Oh, then why didn't he come rescue me?
Good question. Why don't we ask him that when you get there tomorrow morning?
Tomorrow? Oh my gosh, it's almost sunset.
So?
I didn't realize it was so late. We need to make camp.
Make camp? You just escaped.
Yes, and I found the whole ordeal quite exhausting. I need to rest immediately.
Well, that's unfortunate, because we're going to keep going.
I need to find somewhere to camp right now.
Okay, fine. There's a cave over there.
Shrek, there's no place for a princess.
No, it's perfect. Well, gentlemen, I bid thee good night.
Do you want me to read you a bedtime story?
I said good night.
Well, she's nice. Do you want me to read you a bedtime story?
Say good night, donkey.
Good night, donkey.
But wait, there's more to the story. Princess Fiona had a secret. A curse had been placed upon her. By day, one way, by night, another. This shall be the norm.
Until you find true love's first kiss, and then be love's true form.
Chipper.
And why shouldn't I be? It's a new day full of promise and fresh starts.
It is?
Yes. And the first thing I'd like to do is apologize for my behavior yesterday. We obviously got off the wrong foot, and I'd like to make it up to you.
You would?
Yes. You did rescue me after all, so I've gathered a basket full of berries for the trip and made you each a daisy chain. We got a long journey ahead of us. To Duloc.
If you say so, come on, let's go.
Oh yes, a road trip! Punch buggy!
Ow! So, tell me about my groom-to-be, Lord Farquaad. What's he like?
Well, let's just say men of
Farquaad's stature are in short supply.
Really?
Yeah, and very good at small talk.
What are you doing?
Well, I'm saying you might want to lower your expectations like 3 feet or so.
All right, yuck it up. Doesn't bother me. Not today. After a lifetime of misery, things are finally going my way.
It must have been nice having a living in a dragon guarded tower.
It was.
That you had a roof and a bed, which is more than I had when I left home.
You're not actually comparing yourself to what I endured.
I'm just saying, you don't corner the market for unhappy childhoods.
There are things you don't know, you know, about me, about how rough I had it.
In that cushy, you ran out of shampoo a couple times?
I mean about my life.
In that cushy tower of yours?
Cushy? Are you kidding?
I had nothing in that tower, fighting boredom by the hour. Princess lonely, walking circles, I had only bare essentials, army caught a hot plate and a chamber pot, and every morning I would boil it. No choice, I had no toilet, just a view of devastation, out one window isolation in my bedroom, and very little headroom. 20 years I sat and waited, I'm very dedicated. On the walls the days were added, luckily those walls were padded. So I think I got you beat, I think I got you beat. Yeah, 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 I think I got you beat, I think I got you beat.
Oh, you think so? That was a sad story, but I for better. I'm just saying, A forever, thanks for playing. Sad to see a princess lover, but I had it rougher. Like that time with mom with torches, burned my britches, he just scorches. You're just whining. I had a flaming hiney. As I fled, I had to wonder if I was torn asunder. Would an ogre go to heaven? Did I mention I was 7? So I think I've got you beat. I think I've got you beat. Yeah, 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 yeah. I think I've got you beat. I think I've got you.
Better out than in, I always say.
I got you beat, I think I got you beat.
Yeah,
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 yeah.
I think I got you beat, I think I got you beat.
Beat.
There's something going around here. I've been watching and those signals are clear. A nervous laugh when she brushes her skin. The sweaty palms, the big dopey grin. When a giggle and a flip of her hair, I saw the fear moans in the air. Making goo eyes over her food, dangling my hoof here, setting the mood. You gotta turn up the heat, you gotta butter the pan, you gotta make a move and don't be afraid. Reach for her hand, maybe give her a kiss, she's waiting for a move to be made. You gotta, 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 yeah, gotta make a move, you 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 gotta make a move, yeah.
Here we are, Duloc.
I didn't realize we were so close. Maybe Duloc could wait until morning?
Morning?
Why not? I spend my whole life without true love. What's one more night?
Here, princess, you must be hungry. Try this. It's a smeller, sort of like a s'mores, but instead of chocolate and marshmallows, it's grow gizzards and mulch. They just melt in your mouth.
Shrek, I know you can't hear me right now, but if you come, I'd like to say a few things. I'm in your corner, buddy, and you got to tell this girl how you're really feeling. Deep down, you may not get another chance
so just open your heart.
Princess?
Yes, Shrek?
I was wondering. I was wondering. Are you gonna eat that?
Man, what is wrong with you? You gotta turn up the heat, you gotta butter the pan, you gotta make a move and don't be afraid. Reach for her hand, maybe give her a kiss. She's waiting for a move to be made. You gotta, yeah, gotta make a move, you 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 gotta make a move.
Oh, sorry, I was just caught up in the beautiful sunset of the fireflies.
Sunset? Oh my gosh, it's late. I'm sorry, but I have to go.
All right.
Good night.
Oh, no, sir. No way. I didn't come this whole way dealing with your body odor just for you to let her walk away like that.
What are you talking about?
I'm an animal, but I got instincts, and you guys are definitely digging each other.
I'm just returning her to Farquaad.
So you got any feelings for her, any?
Look, even if I did, which I'm not saying I do, because I don't, she's a princess, and, well, I'm an...
ogre?
Yes, an ogre.
She got to know what you're feeling.
Where are you going?
To get more firewood. Your fire's gonna die. Did you see that? Man, it's dark out here. Good thing I got that firewood.
Ooh, maybe you're talking in a barn.
I'm just gonna go check. Shrek? Princess Fiona? I ain't playing no games. It's very spooky in here. Shrek, help me! Shrek, help me!
Donkey, it's okay.
Princess Fiona, what happened to you?
By day one way, by night another. This shall be the norm until you find true love's first kiss. Then take love's true form.
That's beautiful. I didn't know you wrote poetry.
It's a curse. I've had it since I was a girl.
A curse?
A witch cast a spell on me. So now, every night when the sun goes down, I become this horrible, ugly beast.
But, you know, Shrek and you have a lot in common.
Shrek?
I think maybe, is Shrek new to this?
No, he can't know, and you can't tell him. Not a word, no one must ever know. Promise you won't tell, promise?
All right, I won't tell him, but you should, man. After this, I'm gonna need seriously a lot of therapy after this.
I can't think about Shrek, not now. I'm a princess after all, and look at me. I mean, really, who could love a beast so hideous and ugly? Princess and ugly don't go together. That's why I can't stay here with Shrek. My only chance to live happily ever after is to marry my one true love.
Good morning, morning dove. I had a long
gotta go fast. Yeah.
Shrek, thank goodness. There's something I have to tell you.
You don't have to tell me anything. I heard everything last night.
You heard what I said?
Yeah, every word, especially if you love such an ugly, hideous beast.
But I thought that wouldn't matter.
Well, it does.
Whoa, broomstick car, Princess Fiona.
As I promised, now about my swamp.
Spirit Elf has agreed. The deed has been put in your name. Now step away before I change my mind. Sorry for starting you, Princess. I'm Lord Farquaad. I am Lord Farquaad.
Lord Farquaad, forgive me for I was just saying a short farewell.
Oh, that's so sweet. There's no reason to waste such good manners on the ogre. It's not as like as feelings.
No, you're right. It doesn't.
Princess Fiona, beautiful, flawless Fiona. May I ask, in the name of marriage, will we be the perfect bride for the perfect groom?
Lord Farquaad, I accept. Nothing would make me...
Excellent. I start the plans for tomorrow. We wed.
No. I mean, why wait? Let's get married today, before sunset.
Anxious we are. The sooner the better. Captain, ride ahead and tell them it's a cold red. We will be married by sunset.
No. There's nothing good like a good night's sleep. What did I miss?
Fare thee well, ogre.
Shrek, what are you doing? You're letting it get away. There's something you don't know. I talked to her last night and...
Yeah, I heard you two talking. You guys are great pals, aren't you? Why don't you go follow her home?
But I want to go home with you.
With me? You want to go home with me?
What?
No, I live in my swamp alone. Just me, nobody else. Especially pathetic, useless, annoying, talking donkeys.
But I thought...
Well, you thought wrong.
Man, just when you think life can't get any worse, you'll get evicted from a swamp.
Well, look who it is.
Instead, you had us kicked out.
Well, what did you expect from an ogre?
We believe in you.
I'll grow up.
I won't grow up.
Then get out my way.
There he goes again, pushing everyone away like he did to me and Fiona. You're so wrapped up in layers, onion boy. You're afraid of your own feelings.
Who's Fiona?
Mind your business, ducky.
It's a princess who loves him.
Ooh, there's a girl.
That was getting interesting.
The princess loves him.
Okay. Loves me? No, she called me an ugly, hideous beast.
She wasn't talking about you. She was talking about
somebody else.
Who's she talking about?
Oh, now he's interested. 2 minutes ago, he was like, don't talk to me. Go away. I don't need nobody.
Damn. Look, I'm sorry, Donka. I guess I am just a big, stupid, ugly ogre.
Listen up, ogre. We spent our whole lives wishing we weren't so freaking strange. They made us feel that way. But it's they who need to change.
The way they think, that is.
Let your freak flag wave.
My what?
Let your freak flag fly. Never take it down, never take it down. Raise it way.
Had
Excuse me, could we just skip to the I do's?
I do.
I do.
Stop the wedding!
Shrek?
Sorry. Princess, I need to talk to you.
Okay. Ew, showing up with your uninvited pregame friends?
Oh, now you want to talk. Well, it's a little too late for that, so if you'll excuse me.
Look, Lord Farquaad only wants to marry you so you can become king.
That's outrageous, Fiona. Don't listen to him! Guard, take this abomination out of my sight!
No, I mean, let's hear what the monster has to say. It might be worth a laugh.
You heard her, ogre. Express yourself with a few grunts as possible.
Right, okay,
it's a big, bright, beautiful world with possibilities everywhere. If true love is blind, maybe you won't mind the view. You've never read a book like this, but fairy tales should really be updated. It's a big
was lost in the mail.
If you didn't abandon me in the woods.
Abandon you? You were 28 living in my basement.
I'm a big man I have a castle. Not a freak.
People of Dulang, your leader is a halfling.
Stop the wedding.
Fiona?
I wanted to show you before.
Well, this explains a lot.
Ew, it's disgusting! All this hocus pocus alters nothing. I have my crown, see? This makes me king. See? As for you, my wife, I have you locked up in that tower for the rest of your days.
Actually, that won't happen. I would like you to meet a friend of mine. True love.
Yeah, I know, and I'm yours.
Y'all gotta watch this. Shrek and Fiona just kissed, so now Fiona is gonna turn into that beautiful princess we saw before.
By day one way, by night another, this shall be the norm.
Until you find true love's first kiss,
then take love's true form.
True
True form. True form. True form.
Fiona, are you all right?
Well, yes, but I don't understand. I'm supposed to be beautiful.
But you are beautiful.
I waited all my life, lived it by the book. Now I know that's not my story. You take me as I am, love me as I look, standing here in all my glory. I'm sweetness, I am bratty, I'm a princess, I'm a fatty, I'm a mess of contradictions in a dress. I am sassy, I am sappy, when I'm with you, I am happy. This is my story.
You laugh at all my jokes, even though they're rude. You don't mind that I'm not classy. We make a perfect
doggies, we are hairy, we are bold and brand new stories to be told. You will ride them, you will tell them, you will hear them, you will smell them. This is our story.
And this is how the little ogre came to live on a slump with a beautiful princess.
And his best friend.
Okay.
And an ugly duckling.
And a witch.
And a big bad wolf.
The Green Pig.
What makes us special? What makes us special? What makes us special? Makes us strong. We are puppets. We are rabbits. We are hobbits with bad habits. We're truly busted.
I love was more or less.
Okay, come on back, everybody. Main players, come on back. Let's give them the choir down there. Can they come up? The choir, here they come. Let's walk out, choir. Come on, choir, give them a big round of applause. Everybody's here, let's stand up. Give them a big round of applause. All the effort, the memorization, the practice while they're doing their work. So let's give them a big round of applause and a standing ovation. Let's go, ladies and gentlemen.
Un aplauso muy fuerte a todos los actores, los cantantes. Se hicieron, invirtieron muchas horas para brindarles esta obra. So, felicidades a todos, gracias a los padres.
Once upon a time, there was a little ogre named Shrek who lived with his parents in a bog by a tree.
It was a really nasty place, but he was happy because ogres like nasty.
On his birthday, the little ogre's parents sat him down to talk,
just as all ogre parents had for hundreds of years before.
Listen, son, you're growing up so quickly.
Although we want you here, the rules are very clear.
Now you're 7.
Now you're 7.
So it's time to go away.
Your mama packed a sandwich for your trip. Your papa packed your boots in case of snow. You're gonna make us proud. No backing up allowed. Just keep walking.
Just keep walking.
It's a big, bright, beautiful world with happiness all around. It's peaches and cream, and every dream comes true, but not for you.
They look at us, they tend to make a fuss.
Burn our houses down
and chase us
off our land. It's important that you find a cozy settlement, a place no one would ever dare to tread. And if they happen by, make sure you terrify them.
Himself a muddy patch of swamp land,
far, far away where the world had despised him. And there he stayed away for many years, tucked away and all alone.
Which is just the way I like it. Keep your big, bright, beautiful world. I'm happy where I am, all alone. I got all I need, so read the stinking sign.
Keep your big, bright, beautiful world. I party on his own anyway, doing what he can with the one man.